Oh, they're up here. Got one down. Please don't start attacking again. Whoa. Two assassins disappeared after they determined that I was stronger than them in combat, sort of. I do not know who ordered them, but perhaps I can find some hints in the remains of the caravan. Nothing else attack me, please. Miners? Are they part of the caravan? Locket of the Golden Sickle. Report to Mendelis. Yep, we'll report to Mendelis. Phew. All that and I didn't even get to kill them. That's not fair. Bye. Well, technically he's coming with me. He's just gonna get banished once he gets there. Banished.
Hear my words, O path abiding people of this holy city. A miracle has happened.
You're not from
that must or have been due to its sheer glory brought forth by Malthus himself.
Huh? Can I help you?
As I'm running past you full speed, no, you cannot help me. That's not it.
Oh shit.
Oh shit.
Yes? Walk blessed.
The caravan was ambushed. Everybody's dead.
I beg your pardon?
Dead, you know, not living. They made camp in a clearing near the desert. It seems two people took out the entire caravan.
Wait. Again, from the beginning.
Well, you see,
a righteous path.
One day I was born, and then
I mean, the guildmaster must learn of this at once. And wait, what did you say these assassins look like?
Ninjas or something. They were veiled, and they didn't speak Enderal, some language I've never heard before. Well, that's what that guy says. Enderal bad, is he? He's bad at the language, that's what they say.
Oh. Was their armor all black? And did they speak a language that sounded like gibberish to you?
Yes.
Petrified. By Malthus. This is worse than I expected.
Petrified? Who are these petrified?
The hired killers. The best of their kind. Have you never heard of them?
Nope.
Apparently their temple, as they call it, or their headquarters, is on a small island called Milea, a deserted city. But now is not the time for history lessons. Whoever has enough money to hire the petrified is dangerous. Very dangerous.
But you expected something to happen, didn't you? This wasn't an ordinary caravan. Tell me the truth.
I don't like your tone. But if your life depends on it, no, it wasn't.
Too bad.
And yes, I was afraid something might happen.
I like my
tone. Nothing like this. With the entire caravan murdered. By the Seven, this is bad.
So what now?
As I said, Guildmaster Dal'Loran needs to learn about this. Did you find anything on the corpses? The documents, perhaps?
This amulet. Rodas, the caravan leader, had this amulet on him. It looks valuable.
Rodas' amulet. Oh, by Malphus. Dal'Loran will not like this. Give it to me. The Guildmaster will want to have it. Give me back that letter. Well, we have to make sure it doesn't fall into the wrong hands.
Here. I'm sorry. I had to read it.
You had to do what?
Oops.
Oh, by the righteous path. If the circumstances were any different, this would have been the last job you've ever done for us. Here, take this. It's a paycheck, and you can hand it in at the bank. Now, excuse me. I have to make some arrangements. Oh, by the Seven, this is not going to be pleasant.
Pay note. All right. Sweet! Leveled up again. This time health. So keep dying.
Yes?
Oh, so you have ambrosia.
Well, a bit of everything. Just look for yourself.
Nope. No ambrosia. Should be outside,
walk
though.
Walk blessed.
Yeah, I keep making him mad. So I have a pay note. Pay note of the Golden Sickle. The payment is to be paid to the carrier of this note. Doesn't even say how much. Well, let's go to the bank. Since I'm right here.
Some shifts never end.
Until they do.
Hungry for arcane secrets? I have books, scrolls, anything for friends of path-abiding maps.
Ambrosia?
Walk blessed. Right from the farmer's coast. Sure, take a look.
Yeah, I need some of this stuff. Yeah, it's expensive as hell. Jeez. Highway robbery. I'll take two. I wonder if she'll buy some of this stuff. No, just the staves. Oh, I didn't mean to sell that. Well, that's just as well. Take these fireball scrolls. Teleport to Farmer's Coast. Yeah, we can offset it with some of this stuff. Oh, is this just gives you tier learning? Okay, cool. I thought it was something you could use learning points on.
Walk blast.
Yeah, I'll take that. Oh, I think it's under consumables. Oh wait, it's not wrong one. There we go. I guess that worked. Alright. Is this the bank? I believe so. Yes.
Hello. Walk blessed, my dame. How can Sylwyn and friends serve you today?
I have a paycheck from Mendelus Penny Pouches. He said I could hand it in here.
Penny Pouches? So that old man found himself a new errand boy, did he?
Not boy.
Sure me. Yes, this looks solid indeed. Here is your money.
350. Okay, he just couldn't just give me the money. Well, now I returned him in the list. Okay.
Hear my words, O path abiding people of this holy city. Many of you may have heard it already.
Who are you? Hey, you're an adventurer, aren't you? Have you been to?
Oh, I did hear the boy say that, actually, yeah. I remember now. Yep. Just had no idea where the petrified were.
Walk now, if it isn't the heroine of the hour.
Oh! I didn't click anything. Oh, man. I wanted to hear that or read that. Who exactly is Mael Dal'Loran? I've heard that name before. How you say it?
Oh, you did? I'm impressed. Particularly since he's the grandmaster of this guild.
I see. Where can I find him?
In the guild house, just on the other side of the street. Now hurry, he doesn't like to be kept waiting.
Why so snappy?
If that's what snappy sounds like to you, maybe you should consider a change of profession. I heard the bathing house is still looking for harlots.
Oh. Look, if you have a problem with me, just tell me, then we can resolve this.
Oh, there is no problem. At least not a problem that needs resolving. Let me put it this way. I'm impressed by how you, without a moment's hesitation, use the tragic events at the caravan site for your own advantage.
My own advantage?
But I guess that's just how this world works. Business is business.
Yeah, how in blazes did I use anything that happened there to my own advantage?
Forget about it. You wouldn't understand even if I told you.
What? Whatever.
Walk blessed.
I did what I was supposed to do, except I read the letter. Now they're across the street? I thought they were like further down the built. Yeah, I guess they're across the street.
Walk blessed.
There's no. Wait. Right there, okay. Yeah, I've snuck into this place before.
Hungry for arcane secrets? I have books, scrolls, potions, anything for friends of path-abiding magic.
Is there any other way in there?
Walk blessed.
Hear my words, O path.
You're not from here, are you? I heard you talk.
Greetings.
I gotta pick my way in there.
Oh shit. I have to remember that.
I just don't see the fucking point.
He doesn't see the point in remembering it. Oh, it's not locked.
Work, work, work.
Yeah, I never actually went up here. Protector of the Golden Sickle?
Mm-hmm.
I think I've seen you before, haven't I? You work for the Order. Do you know who those wild mages up in the temple are? I mean, sure, if the Grand Master trusts them, who am I to doubt his decision? But still, I don't know.
I don't really care what you don't know.
The light fades away at the end of the day. Ta-dum-dum.
Such a lovely singer.
Now, a good pipe of peace, Wayne. Blazes, why is that stuff so expensive?
Can't really afford to carry that. $57 coins, nice. Here. Thank you very much.
Take a seat.
On me. I look at your books first. Another 14 coins. Now all set. You coming? Okay. I missed some coins.
Good. Thank you for coming. I'm Mael Dal'Loran, by my path, Guildmaster of the Golden Sickle. What is your name?
Topaz. Well met.
Well met. I'll be frank. You're an outlander, and that makes you pathless. And I'm sure you know by now that the Golden Sickle is more than just a band of merchants. It's a citadel of traditional values in a time when they hardly exist anymore. Still, I believe that everyone has the right to prove themselves, pathless or not. And when you fought those assassins, you did just that.
Good to hear.
Even though you were too late. So, as promised, I'll make it short. I want to promote you to the rank of Protector.
Really? What about that guy outside? Is he getting fired? I've only just started in your guild. Doesn't a promotion like that usually take longer?
It does. But the circumstances are anything but ordinary.
One question. Is this the guild house of the Sickle? I imagine it would be different.
How? With floors made of marble and statues of gold? This is not a brothel for nobles. It's a place of work. And in my experience, that kind of nonsense does one thing above all else. Distract.
Hmm. Well, the quartermaster didn't seem very happy for me, to be honest.
That sounds just like him. You know, there were times when Mindalus was young and full of ideals. But his behavior these days continues to remind me that those times are long past. I suppose he thinks your promotion is unfair to the other recruits. But you're fit for the task. Even he should see that.
It's that text we missed. Because it's... He didn't say it. He said the first line and then it just scrolled off... It just disappeared off the screen. So what exactly does that mean? Serve as a protector?
The same as working for the trading post. Only you will no longer have to waste your skills on running errands. You promised to honor the principles of the Golden Sickle, and to never act out against it or its members. In return, you will be granted a good pay and path-abiding honest work. Work that other Outlanders would give their left hand for, if I may say that.
You should know that I have other responsibilities as well. I'll not be available day and night.
You don't have to be. You help the Sickle when it needs help, and you get paid. That's it.
Well, I'm interested.
Good. Can you read and write?
Absolutely.
Excellent. This contract contains what we expect from you in written form. Read it, sign it, and then we can start.
Huh. Read the contract and hand it back to Mael'Doran signed. Look.
What is this, a joke? Read it and sign it.
I charge you $16 coins for that. Where is it? These are all seen. Mael wants to raise me into the rank of a protector of the Golden Sickle. He gave me a contract which I have to read and sign if I want to be a member of the Sickle. Read the contract. Is it just called contract? Right here. Well, the weight is 0.1, that's weird. Contract concerning a protectorate of the Golden Sickle. Agreement between the Golden Sickle and blank. I hereby pledge to serve the Merchants Guild of the Golden Sickle as protector until the revocation of this document. This includes the respect of the guild statutes, Enderalian law, and the righteous path, to never act against the Sickle or its members and or its business partners. Let's remember that. To always adequately represent the Sickle. This includes the above-mentioned rules as well as a decent ethical behavior. Yeah, it could be more and more challenging. A breach of one or more of the above terms will be punished and can result in immediate nullification of the protector contract. The Golden Sickle also reserves the right to alert the Guard of Ark in case of serious offenses. Signatories. Alright. How do I sign it? Is it signed?
Yes.
Ah. Here it is.
Excellent. Then we can start right away. Are you ready for your first assignment as a protector?
I am. What do you need me to do?
Before I tell you, I have to ask you something. Are you familiar with the Blue Islands Coalition? At the end of the day.
I don't have an option to say no, because I am not familiar with the Blue Island Coalition at all. Vaguely?
The Blue Island Coalition is a league of powerful merchants from the Belt of Kilay. I take it you've heard about the civil war on Kilay. It has been going on for 2 years now. Recently, the Council of Elders, which is made up of mostly wealthy merchants in Kilay, succeeded in restoring rudimentary order. That is, if a dictatorship by those cutthroats can be called order.
How did the Civil War start?
Blasphemous rumors about the supposed death of the Lightborn. It's ridiculous when you say it out loud like that. But the Kalaeans never were a god-fearing people to begin with. I suppose some of the elders were behind those rumors. They wanted all the power for themselves, so they spread a rumor that the gods were dead, and that it was time for a new order to arise. At first, it was just a few remaining servants of the Lightborn against the usurpers. Then the latter started turning on each other. Thousands of people died. Although the Kalaeans brought this upon themselves, it's still a tragedy.
And how exactly does that affect us?
It affects trade. Since the Civil War, the prices for spices, cane sugar, and Kalaeian cloth have exploded. And while some might profit from this, most merchants don't. But this situation should settle down now that the war is over. And it's not the topic of this discussion. I need you because some days ago an emissary of the Blue Islands Coalition arrived in Ark.
Work, work, work.
They sent an emissary? Despite the wars?
Yes, but it's no ordinary visit. We'll talk of that later.
You don't seem to hold this Council of the Elders in high regard, do you?
I don't. But that's a different story.
Guess so. So what's my role in this?
I want you to meet this emissary and give him this letter. It's a written invitation to come to the Guild's house for dinner.
Wait, I thought you said becoming a protector would free me from running errands.
We are talking about a representative of one of the world's most powerful merchant guilds. This is not an ordinary errand.
I understood. Where can I find this emissary?
Well, finding that out will be part of your job. But I suppose he's somewhere in that city where there are colorful clothes and shining jewels. Kalaeans are drawn to that kind of flashiness like children to sweets. Now go. Come back to me once you've delivered the message.
Present the emissary of the Blue Islands Coalition with the invitation.
Yes?
Work, work, work.
You just have to work if you want to achieve something. It's just how it is.
24 more coins. Alright, so this, he might be an Ark Foreign Quarter.
Stop ignoring me.
Never. Here in the Dancing Nomad.
In no bed, sorry.
Yes, you should go into the Whispering Wood and see what you can find in the old fortress. In the Undercity, in my laboratory.
Mind if I sit?
Oh, she no talk to Dool. In all bad, talk to others.
It won't take long. You're here with the Blue Islands Coalition, aren't you? I'm looking for your emissary.
Emissary? She talk about the jam. The jam not here. The jam other place. Perhaps Dul can remember, but she needs to help his memory. Dul's memory old and full of holes, like cheese.
Old and full of holes? You're still in your 20s.
She right. But sailor life is rough. And sea winds blow away thoughts, just like that. Dul heard that pennies can help, but Dul not knows if true.
Oh, wait, the course. Oh! Now I can go back to and see what happened with that guy's daughter. I should have moved this thing, but I was afraid some people would react to me moving it, like stealing it. Alright then, here's your money. Now tell me where I can find this Dijam.
Ah, she very generous. Oh, and look, memories come back.
How miraculous.
Dijam went bathing in house with many waters. She look there. She has what she came here for. Go now. Leave Dul alone.
Search him in the bathhouse or search for him?
She has what she came here for.
It's in the nobles' quarter, right? The bathhouse?
My dame.
Signpost around here somewhere?
Yes?
New.
Walk blessed, madame.
Noble's quarter.
An obelus, my dame, please.
No obelus. What's on the other side, isn't it? Yeah, here it is. Hi.
Walk blessed, walk blessed. Has my dame come to indulge in the hot springs of the Larkses? Or is my dame simply looking for a place to forget about life's daily sorrows? In either case, she will be required to pay a toll of 57 pennies.
Oh, come on. I don't want to pay any pennies. I'm looking for someone. His name is Dijam, a Kalayan. Any chance he's around here somewhere?
Unfortunately, a man with such a name is not known to me. Or is my dame simply looking for a place to... My dame! You should cover yourself with...
Let's talk downstairs, shall we? I want to indulge in these beautiful springs for as long as I can.
Wait a minute, you're Dijam?
As far as I know, yes. Dijam Onelis, daughter of Juran, emissary of the Blue Islands Coalition, and newcomer to this wonderful city. But let's save the introductions for later, shall we? It's cold up here.
Sounds like a plan.
It does. Come on down.